me down. Don't bring me down. Don't bring me down. Don't bring me down.
I'm going to be showing you guys how I bleach the knots on a lace closure. Now this hair that I have here is Burmese loose wave from Dyhair777. I was sent this hair to review and I got 4 bundles of their Burmese loose wave in inches 20, 22, 24, 24, and I'm actually not sure what inch closure this is, but it really doesn't matter right now. It's probably about 16 or 18 inches, so we'll just go with that. So as you all can see, the knots are not bleached, therefore if I were to apply the lace closure to my head right now, it really wouldn't look natural, even though I already have something.
Yeah, if you guys can see, the lace closure still has the black knots. So bleaching the closure is what we're gonna do just to get rid of the black knots and have a more natural appearance when it is applied to the scalp.
So when you're bleaching the knots on your closure, of course you're gonna get the closure. I also use my styrofoam head and my wig stand right here, and I also have like something just to make sure that the wig head doesn't come off. But also you're going to need 2 of these types of pins with the balls on the end, so you can secure the lace closure down to the cap. I mean, not the cap, but to the head while you're putting the bleach on it, so that it doesn't move and all that other stuff. Okay guys, so when I bleach my closures, I use the Clear All Professional 4 Soyplex Pure White and 40 Volume, along with the Clear All BW2 powder. Then I also have a small container which I mix my bleach developer and the actual powder bleach. And also you're going to need one of the applicators and also some aluminum foil to cover the hair while it's processing. So first, I actually like to start off with the developer. So I actually just eyeball it. I never really measure out how much to use. And the thing about the consistency in the bleach when you're bleaching your knots on your closure, you do not want the consistency to be runny, because if you do, the hair is going to get bleached because the bleach is actually running through that lace and getting on the roots of the closure. So this is all I have right now. It's not much. So I'm just going to add in my BW2 powder until it gets clumpy. Well, not clumpy, but to a thick paste, so it's not, you know, runny whenever I mix it up. You're just gonna mix up your developer and your bleach, making sure that you get everything mixed evenly so that you can get a rich consistency that's not runny, so it won't run through the lace on your closure. And if you see that it's too runny, then you should just definitely go back and add some more powder. Do not go back and add developer. All you need from this point on is the powder. So as you can see, it's still kind of runny, so I don't want that, so I'm going to add some more bleach powder. Okay, so this is the consistency I have from mixing everything together, and it is very, very thick. It's not going anywhere, it's not falling anywhere. So this is what I'm gonna be using to apply onto my closure, my knots. So I highly advise that if you have gloves, I recommend you using them, because it does get messy and you don't want the bleach to actually interfere with your skin, because right now my hands feel really gritty and my nose is suffering from the smell of this bleach. So I'm just gonna put my gloves on. Okay guys, so from this point, you're just gonna take the tip end of your applicator and slowly start to just pat the product, well, the bleach onto the knots, making sure that you're patting it in gently and you're not pressing it through to the hair so that it doesn't bleach the hair. You don't want that, because trying to touch up the roots after you bleach them or over process them, and the lace closure is really hard, so just be as careful as you can. Gonna look like after about 15 minutes of processing. Now I'm just gonna shampoo the bleach out, and then that'll be it. The knots in your closure, this is what it should look like. The knots should not be black, they should have a tint, a bleach tint to them, so when you apply it on your scalp, it won't, you know, look unnatural and antsy. And the scalp part looks very realistic, so when you apply it to your scalp, it's not gonna look lace closure-y, even though it is a lace closure. Okay guys, and that concludes my tutorial on how I bleach my knots. I hope you guys found this very helpful. I actually wasn't requested to do this video, at least I don't think I was, but I figured that it'd be very helpful since I'm about to, you know, actually use this closure, and I just wanted to show you all how I prep them, so you all wanted to know, you know, how I make my lace closures look pretty natural against my scalp. So I hope you guys enjoyed it, and if you did, definitely thumbs up this video, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.